Hi, welcome to this Easy Composites tutorial on kayak repair. What we're going to be doing is looking over this boat that's had a bit of damage and just going through the different areas and showing you the best way to repair that. So let's take a look at the damage that we've got. On the sides here, it's had a crush and it's fractured the laminate just down here, and again the same on the other side. So we're going to be creating a patch over that to give it its rigidity back and to stop it from leaking. We've got another area here, which is where it's taken a hit, and again, it's taken out the top coat of the resin. And then at the nose of the kayak here, we've got damage to the Kevlar joining trim. And also, just on the underside, there's quite a severe fracture just here, which again, we'll be doing a patch just over the underside of the nose there. The first thing you need to do with any repair is make sure that the area is fully prepared for the bond. Now, to do this, you need a very coarse abrasive, 120 grit at the finest. Really, anything down to between 80 and 120 is perfect. So any loose bits of material, remove those with a knife or with a chisel, or sand them away until you're back down to the most solid material you can find underneath. So we're just looking to thoroughly sand the area beyond where you see the fracture, because very often with composites, the fractures run a lot further than it looks like on the surface. So your patch wants to cover a good 2 inches, 50 millimeters beyond the edge of the visible cracks all the way around. Now we're going to look at the Kevlar edging tape. It's important with this, any damaged areas, cut them out and remove them, and then just lap another section of the tape, the braided tape, over the top. So the first thing to do, as I say, is cut it out. Sharp knife is the best way of doing it. If you try and sand Kevlar, it goes very fluffy and you'll soon end up in a mess. In this nose area, we've got quite severe damage. That's a full fracture into the hull. So what we're going to do here is build up an extra patch of material just over the fracture, and then another one that laps over the top. And then finally, once we've done that, we'll bring it over the tape here, and then we'll lay another band of tape over the top and lap it all together. So now we're going to cut the material for the repair. Here, obviously, we're using a carbon Kevlar. That's clearly what this hull's made from. However, it's quite common to have Dylan hulls. The same resin systems and the same processes all apply. Likewise, with some of the racing kayaks, they'll be full carbon. And again, you can do the repair with full carbon. Or indeed, on more basic ones, just fiberglass. So the process remains the same. It's just a case of pre-cutting your material, getting everything prepared before you actually mix the resin and go in on the repair. Kevlar can be notoriously difficult to cut. Here we're using Kevlar shears. They do make your life significantly easier. And it also results in a neater repair. We're now going to be using a Kevlar flat braid, which is commonly used around the edge of the kayak for joining the upper and lower hulls. We're just going to be using it around that front area where we've got the damage to the original braid. This is release film. It's a very thin, fairly stretchy film that is designed not to stick to resin. So once we've done the repair over the front, we're going to be using this and stretching it over the repair to give it a nice, smooth, even finish. Now we're going to mix up the resin. We're using Easy Composites Rapid Repair Resin. It's got very high flexural strength, which means it can flex without cracking and breaking, which is obviously important on a kayak. It's also got very, very good laminate bond strength to existing either polyester or epoxy hulls, so that way your repair will stay firmly attached and won't peel. It's very important that you mix resin as accurately as you possibly can, so a good set of scales and thorough mixing is really key to making sure that your repair is sound. First, looking to brush resin over the repair, making sure it penetrates really well into any cracks. now apply first layer of reinforcement. You can see immediately when the resin is wetted into the fibre thoroughly. The second layer of reinforcement that we're applying overlaps both the seam on the tape and the first layer. Need to be very careful around any areas where you've cut the fibre. If you're too rough with it, it's very easy to fray it. And although it won't structurally affect the repair, it won't look as neat. Once you've wetted out all the fibre nice and evenly, just give it a little brush over of a little bit of extra resin. And then when we stretch the release film over the top, we can squeegee that out and it'll leave a nice, consistent, even finish. What we're going to do, trim off the excess of the release film, and then we're going to tape it back to hold it tightly over the repair. The odd little wrinkle won't matter. That'll soon knock out and smooth out on the final part. Once the repair has been filmed over, any small air bubbles that you see inside can just be pushed to the edge underneath the film. And as you can see, you end up with a very smooth, consistent finish. That's now ready to be left. We've used a fast hardener, so the release film could be removed from that in as little as 3 or 4 hours. So we're going to move now onto the repairs. Just wiping over the area here with an alcohol wipe just to degrease it thoroughly and make sure again that we get as good a bond as we possibly can. We're using a slightly different technique here on these side things because they're more complicated and it's very awkward to get brushes into there. We're just going to be wetting out the fibre on a piece of release film on the table here and then taking that and placing it onto the hull of the kayak, as you'll see. Right, I've mixed up a new batch of resin here and we're going to just apply that down onto both the hull itself and onto the reinforcement here, because you still want to make sure you've got the coat down, even though we're using a patch method, coat down on the part to penetrate into the fibres that are exposed there. Using this patch method on the sides is very straightforward. Once it's all wetted out, we simply apply the patch down onto the surface, pressing it firmly against it to make sure it's in full intimate contact, and then it's just a case, as we've done on the nose, of stretching the film down as tightly as we can and taping it down into place. With these side sections, it's quite an intricate shape, so getting the film completely smooth isn't really going to be a possibility, so we'll have to accept some slight wrinkles that we'll address later on. Right, these repairs are now ready to be left. We're just going to leave these to cure overnight and then we're going to come back to it, look at finishing them up to a nice standard, and also putting a little bit of resin over in that gel coat repair at the front there. You can see how easily the release film removes from the repair. It doesn't stick at all to the cured resin. The finish that we've got on the nose here is absolutely spot on. The release film has left a totally smooth and consistent finish. So we're just going to look at tidying up the two repairs at the side of the boat now. Now, because we couldn't get as much tension on the release film on these areas, it's left a very slight wrinkle onto the surface. So what we're going to do is just flat that out and coat it with resin to seal it again. When you're sealing in the fibres here, you want to make sure that you go beyond the edge of your line there. That'll seal the repair to the rest of the hole. And when you've keyed it up, you should have keyed up just beyond the repair, because if you were to apply this onto an area of the boat that wasn't keyed up, you'd run the risk of it wanting to come off.
Moving on now to the areas that require a repair to the gel. Having already sanded these back and prepared them, simply a case of using some of the mixed resin and bleeding it into the surface. We've built it up to roughly the level of the rest of the hull, and now we're taking a release film, stretching it tightly over the surface, adding a little bit of extra resin just to get it to the level, completely level with the surface. Then, as before, just stretch the film out, tape it down, and squeegee it out where necessary to get it completely flush with the surface.
We've removed the release film from these two repairs now. The finish is really smooth and even. We're not going to sand that. That would risk exposing the fibres again. So really now, that's all of the repairs on this boat done. That concludes our kayak repair tutorial. I hope you found all the information in this video of use. And remember, you can buy all of these specialist kayak repair materials on our website, www.easycomposites.co.uk.